You are now watching the M2 show.
Yeah. So happy. I mean, apart from acting, I mean, it's acting like your full-time job.
Right now, no. But I've always loved acting. Like I said before, when we started, I started in improv. I started doing improv, a soap opera, but it was improv. Acting for me is like a way of relieving stress. I can go to my 9-to-5. I'm a nurse. I go to my 9-to-5. It's chaotic and whatever. But I can be in a production set all day. Ask Mohamed, like, even when we was doing the movie, all of us, it would, even if it's not our time to go on, you know,
On set.
We will still be over there laughing sometime, you know, they tell
me. That's the beauty of production. Yeah.
So it's
the beauty.
Acting is like the thing for me. But that's, I'm just gradually getting up, trying to get there.
That's the beauty.
Taking baby steps.
That's the beauty.
That's the beauty of production.
She did a very good job, you know. I just told her that, you know, she's one of my PA, you know. She's not only playing the movie, but she act as a PA in that movie, because anytime I want to call the girls, you know, I have to call her phone. I'd be like, hey, tell me, I need this girl. Desmond said she need one of the girls to come on set right now. I don't even call the girl. Sometimes, hey, you know, woman thing, you know, the lips come out sometimes, you know. Like, Mohamed, don't call my phone anymore. I'm sleeping. I wake up 4:00 in the morning and I'm still up. Come on. You know, so it's crazy. And all of them did a very good job. From Bella to Sue to Mafanta to Eunisa to Samuela, you know, to Binet to Genefine. Everybody did excellent. And I want to say thanks to every single person in New Jersey, because I was surprised when I'm looking at seeing people. Because when I started, I'm going to tell you this. When I started, people say, oh, you're wasting your time. What are you doing this for? You know, so when they see me now using Nollywood, people will camera for me for nothing. People will hold the boom. They will hold that boom till like 4 in the morning. The last 2 days, this is the funniest thing. You won't believe. The last 2 days for me to finish, wrap up, you know, I was holding the boom in my hand, sleeping. And this one was like, Mohamed, cut. You are sleeping holding the mic. It's not going to work now. This movie. I told you it's hard, but you won't believe me. Say, don't do this job. It's not good. I said, Desmond, I want to do it. So I love the job, you know. And trust me, I'm going to keep going. Help her.
I like when you say you love the job, because me and M2, we don't sleep. We always talking about progress. We are so, camera, technical stuff, we are there. M2 show, Taka Tanni show, we improve, we always, acting with there. We just did a finish a production with there. So the beauty of the move, the entertainment business, the beauty of it is what keeps us alive. M2 and myself, we don't sleep. We're looking for the next project to come up with. So when you talk about the, you know, doing this because of, it's what you want to do, doing this because it's what you really, I mean, it's your passion. Yeah. That's how me and M2, we feel. It's our passion. We love this. We don't do this for, sometimes you think, okay, I'm going to do this because of the money is going to come. No. When you're doing it, first of all, you do it because you enjoy it.
You love it. You will love it. And one thing I will tell you, right? When Desmond sent me my trailer, because I was so eager, I want to see the trailer. I said, Desmond, send me the trailer. So after a month, he sent me the trailer and my phone started blowing off. Oh, man. And people keep calling me. Oh, my God. I was like, oh, what's going on? I saw your movie. Oh, it's nice. I can't wait. When is it coming? I said, I don't know, but it's coming out pretty soon, you know. Okay. And people, when are you doing your next version? Please call me. If I tell you, I have to change my phone number. Just... So, you know, because at one time when I was doing a audition, I put my phone number, my email address. My phone was blown. People call me, talking to me. I said, damn, it's New Jersey. It's 2 a.m. in the morning. Why are you calling me at this time? Oh, I went to Facebook and I saw your advert. I really want to come. When I did my audition, I had people from Canada, Boston, just to come to New Jersey to come do the audition for the movie. And some of them don't even got the job. Some of them got it, you know. And I still have like bunch of people who want to do movies. I'm just what the only thing I'll tell you. Keep doing what you're doing, you know. One day you'll make it up. But the most important thing is when you want to do a movie, just focus and do it, you know. Right. Go ahead with it, because people will tell you, oh, you're wasting your time. Or, yeah, you know, the industry we find ourselves is really rough. Right. That I will tell you, you know. Because some actors or actress, they do the job. But I will tell you, at the other end, they're doing some kind of crazy stuff. So, like, but the industry, I love it. And
you know, like you just said, keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah.
The production we just did, me and M2 Show, we did a production. It's not easy. That's why having you on this show talking about your production, mm-hmm, it's very important. It's not easy to do a production. It takes a lot of guts. Hell to yeah. Be a producer, to do mm-hmm. a production. We went through so many things. And then when you give an advice like, keep doing what you're doing, that's a very good production. Psh, what did he do? It's a mediocre production. It's a this, it's a that. Don't look at it. Don't, just do your best.
You're right.
You know, like we going to a premiere today, me and M2. When we get there, the most important thing is make people happy. Do your best. Media handle, do the best you can. You know, so I really commend you for taking that bold step and doing the production, and it's coming out good. You're not having a premiere, right?
No, I did a premiere in New Jersey back in August. Oh. And I did a premiere in 3 Midwest states, you know, and that's come out good. I was hoping to do a premiere down here in DMV, but the promoters, man, they play me out. You know, that's what I would say. So if you're a promoter down in Maryland, you know, you have beef with Medaj Production, big time. But I want to say this, though, you know, thanks to John Uche. You know, he's a very good advisor. He called me and he said, oh, man, you're in your 20s and you handle a big production company. It's crazy, but hey, keep doing what you do, you know. And I said, okay. And when you own a production company, this will happen. I have people who are like my father, you know. The the guy that's taking care of my administration right now, he's old enough to be my father. And when he calls me, sometimes I don't even pick up. He will keep calling me until I pick up. And my advisor, Mr. Busari Savage, oh man. As a matter of fact, as opposed to send my movie to Freetown, you know, he called me at 5 a.m. this morning. Did you send the copy already? Just for me to make sure, you know, these people, they are the one inspiring me just to be, you know, close in the movie industry. And I won't lie to you. Like I told you earlier, I love this industry. I love it. Sometimes I just make fun.
And having people back you up, it's even it's greater.
You should have the right people. If you have the right people, trust me, you will work it out. You know?
It's even greater. Productions will come. You know, see, you and you dress very good tonight.
Thank you.
You know, productions will come. I bet you they will come. Your movie will be out in a week, so productions will come. And I wish you good luck.
Thank you. And just to set the record straight, when Mohamed said he was sleeping, I remember that like it was today. We were shooting a scene. He was sitting down, holding the boom. Desmond sitting here, I'm standing there. We in the middle of a shot. That was like the last take. All of us heard him. Mohamed is snoring. And everybody just fell down, started laughing. So he wasn't actually just sleeping. He was snoring. Oh, and it was like, man. Oh, wow, how do you... And his eyes was open.
And my eyes was... See, that's
how
tired.
So that was...
Because you go on set 9 a.m. in the morning, and you don't leave set till like 4 a.m. in the morning the next day. So that's how it is. And we are trying to rush up time because they have another production to go to. You know, that was a real peak season for Desmond and Van and Uche to, you know, handle it. But trust me, they did a wonderful... I always say Desmond is my boss, you know, because anytime I call him in Nigeria, he call me boss too. Bros, me, I'm tired with this movie. I was telling you. I said, bros, hey, let's do it now. You know, we said we want to shoot movie. Let's shoot it. You know, so we always do it. And one person that inspired me, JJ Bunny, you know, when he started producing movie, and when I called him up, he's so down, you know, he said, go ahead with it, do it. But I'm telling you, the industry is hard. You just have to, you know, get your pants tight for you to get it done. And when I asked him, I said, working with Desmond, was he like, oh, Desmond is so funny. You will laugh from the beginning to the end. Mm-hmm. You know, and I look at it, I say, when Desmond was on my set, oh my God. Sometimes I have to be like, Desmond, let's shoot now. He said, hey, we are shooting. We are just waiting for them to come. You know, so every time it's fun to Desmond. Yeah. Every single thing Desmond open his mouth is fun. So nice. Anytime I call him, he's so down, you know. And one thing I will say, the Mohamed you see talking and when I'm on set is different, I'm telling you, because you know when I'm on set, it's like I'm the boss. Yeah. You know, I go out there, people that really trust me, you know, give me their money, put it in my business. I'm hoping to pay them back, and I'm running against time. So obviously, I have to, you know, I'm not going to sit down there and the money just go like this. You know, I have to make sure that the job is done and everybody, you know, leaves. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I just don't want people to think that, oh, Mohamed is so rude. No, I was not. But I was just playing my job. You know, when you're on set and you're doing regular stuff, it's different, you know. Just like when you go to work, you know, you have your boss. They will fire you. You'll be working. You'll work for like almost 50 years, but they will still get rid of you. One mistake that you make. So
right, that's the beauty of the business. Normally, you don't mix. You know, there's a pleasure when you're doing good business, but when you're spending money, it's a tense period when you're doing movies. So one last word for my actually a quick brief. You know, Mohamed Conteh is married. You know, Mortgage Production. He did In a Man's Mind. It's coming out at the end of the month, January. And Mohamed was inspired by a lot of, you know, beautiful people. And right now, I just want, you know, and your final words.
Final words. Love. Watch African movie, you know. I'm telling you, by this year, 2011, summer, I believe in America, we're surely going to have one of Genevieve best, because we have so many upcoming actors and actresses that did movie this last 2010 summer, you know. And when they call me that, oh, I'm on set, I'm doing a movie right now with this, I say, oh my God, I can't wait for next summer to come out, you know. I have two particular movies that I'm looking at right now. The Yo Yo Babe and This Is Houston. We're definitely going to have a Genevieve over there. You know, we're definitely going to have one star that come out. And trust me, in a man's mind, when you look at that movie, man, you will laugh from the beginning. You will laugh from the beginning to the end, you know. It's a very love story. For all those who are out there who want to do movies, you know, do audition, you know, there are so many social networks these days, you know. You make a video and, you know, send it to producers. I'm not telling you to go, you know, do the nasty stuff with a producer, but, you know, just, I know, like, people will tell you, like, I really talked to one producer that told me, say, Mohamed, there's no way I can spend my money and make an upcoming a star. And then, well, we look at it this way. That's why sometimes it's very hard for us to use upcoming, because after we use them once, maybe twice, and then they become big, when we start calling them for a movie, to come to the start making. Oh, I have a manager now. You have to talk to my manager now. You know.
No. So beautiful music I made for you to just cherish, but I'm debated, disputed, hated, and viewed in America. Look at it like you didn't experiment. Nah. That's when you start to stare at who's in the mirror and see yourself as a kid again, and you get embarrassed. Then I got nothing to do but make you look stupid as parents. You do good, it's too bad you couldn't do good at marriage. And do you have any clue what I had to do to get here? I don't think you do, so stay tuned and keep your ears glued to the stereo, cause here we go. He's chicken, 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 and I'm the sinister Mr. Critical. Never been afraid to say what's on my mind at any given time of day, cause I'm a say what's on my mind at any given time of day, cause I'm a renegade.